folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and welcome to another episode of DGN, a weekly news show where we chat about all the cool new guitar and musical goodies that have landed this past week, and what's happening in the world that's rocking and rolling around us. Here's what's coming up this week. There's been some awesome news dropping this past week. Guns N' Roses have announced a new 4-track EP coming out the start of next year called Hard School. It's been the 30th anniversary of Nirvana's album Nevermind, and some really quirky things have been happening around the world. One of my favourite guitar players, Mr. Jack White, has opened a Third Man record store in London. It's a vinyl store and a gig venue, all in one. Another one of my favourite bands, Limp Bizkit, have released the first new song in 11 years, and it's awesome. And the last bit of news is the fact that there's been some amazing news from the Blink 182 camp. All of these will be timestamped in the description box down below, so if you want to skip to one of the news stories, you can. And product-wise, I'll be chatting about the new Gibson Generation Series acoustic guitars. Shure have released the ultimate podcasting microphone, and some brand new revamped keyboards from Alesis, as well as ending with an awesome little video of an incredible 5-year-old playing some Nirvana in a PMT store. I wish I could play guitar like that when I was 5-year-old. Right, let's get into it. So, new music from Guns N' Roses. This is the first time Slash, Axl Rose and Duff McKagan have been in the same room writing music for 28 years since the Spaghetti Incident. Obviously, we've had Chinese Democracy in the meantime, which I personally think is a great album, Guns N' Roses name aside. It's an awesome album, but it's nice to have something to look forward to, some classic Guns N' Roses coming next year, the 25th of February, I believe, 2022. Now, Duff McKagan has hinted to a full-length album sometime in the future. He stated that he's heard some of the demos that Axl Rose has written and recorded, and he's blown away by them, which is good news for us. But at least this 4-track EP will be a little taster of things to come. We already know 2 tracks of the EP, Hard School, which is the latest single, the title track. Let me know what you think about Hard School down below. I think it's awesome. And Absurd. I wasn't too keen on Absurd. It did grow on me a little bit, but I know a few folk don't like it, a few folk love it. Let me know what you think down below of Absurd, but there's a new EP coming next year. Hard School, a taster of things to come. I can't wait. I love Guns N' Roses, and you can tell that by the new Epiphone Slash collection that was released a few weeks ago. I went hard with that release in that video. Check it out in the description box down below. They're halfway through a US tour right now with support from Mammoth WVH, Wolfgang Van Halen, Eddie's son. So I don't know why they've found the time to write and record, well, to record these songs, but I'm glad they have. Other artists on the album, Richard Fortus on guitar, Frank Ferreira, an amazing drummer, Dizzy Reed, who's also one of the longest standing members of Guns N' Roses besides Axl, but people don't realise that. Melissa Reese as well. Sorry, Melissa, I nearly missed you out there. Those are accompanying Slash, Duff and Axl on the record. There's also going to be live tracks I've read somewhere. I don't know if these are the other two or extra tracks, live versions of Don't Cry and You're Crazy from Appetite for Destruction. I don't know how that rounds out the 4 tracks of the EP. Hopefully not. Hopefully they're just extra tracks, but I can't wait. Let me know if you can't wait as well. Hell yeah. Speaking of iconic bands, on the 24th of September, which was a little while ago now, but I was off last week, so it's fine. It was the 30th anniversary of Nirvana's Nevermind. An iconic album, whether you like grunge music or Nirvana or not, you can't dispute how much of an impact this album had on the world of music and guitar playing in general. And to celebrate this, Nirvana are reissuing the album, as you'd expect, like they did for the 25th and stuff. And the kid's still on the front, even though in DGN a few weeks ago, I explained that the baby from Nevermind is suing the band for unlicensed use of his image, even though he's, like, capitalised on it loads of times. But anyways, it's now been done by a dude in Adelaide in Australia who used the app Strava to cycle around the suburbs of where he lives. And he, like, mapped out the baby from the cover of Nevermind. I mean, the picture does it justice right now. It's absolutely crackers. From The Guardian in Australia, it says Pete Stokes rode about 150 kilometers on a single speed bike to sketch the outline of the famous Nevermind baby. His efforts, tracked by the GPS site Strava, show the baby's slightly angry face over CBD and the banknote over the leafy eastern suburbs of Burnside and Kensington, which I assume are just places in Adelaide. Stokes, who's a National Parks project manager, said it took about 8 hours with bakery stops in between. I think it's awesome. Check out other stuff this guy's done as well. He marks Beethoven's birthday, he draws dinosaurs, he draws birds, but the Nevermind baby is one of the coolest things I've seen to celebrate the 30th anniversary of an iconic album. Now let's talk about gear. This was released last week, but I need to talk about it now because I love these things. These are the new Gibson Generation Series acoustic guitars. Now the fine folk at Gibson let me go down to their UK showroom and demo these guitars before anyone knew. I couldn't tell anyone what I was doing. It was a lot of fun though. And these are guitars that are more the affordable range of Gibson, still made in Bozeman, Montana though, where all the J45s and the very expensive ones are made. And the cool thing about these are they have the Gibson player port, which is a secondary sound hole up the top of the arch here. Now, people might have seen these before on other guitars, but Gibson found a blueprint from the 60s, because they're going through all the drawers trying to find the original ledgers from 1959 and stuff to calibrate the guitars to now and that. They found the blueprint of an acoustic guitar with a sound hole up on the top. And granted, on this blueprint, it was towards the elbow, which is ridiculous because you won't be able to hear yourself, but they've took that process and made it into 2021 for these new guitars, and they don't cost a lot of money. Well, they cost enough. They're not like cheap beginner guitars or something. It is still a proper handmade Gibson. Spruce top, walnut back and sides. There's four different variants. They're going from small compact parlor guitars all the way up to the big jumbo ones. The G00, the G45, the G Writer, and the G200. The G Writer and the G200 are electroacoustic. It has a new LR bags system in it. For more sound demos and stuff, I will just link my video to the demonstrations of the guitars for the release in the description box down below, because they sound absolutely kick-ass. And the G00 and the G45 don't have pickups in them. So there's a size and style of Generation Series to fit any kind of player, and they do make a massive difference. When we first got them in the Newcastle store where I am based right now, people were like, well, is it a novelty? Is it not a novelty? Play it, or come to a PMT store and play one and have someone cover the hole on the top. And it just sounds like a regular acoustic until you move your hand away, and it does make a massive difference. It's like having a separate monitor on stage for you, but you're getting to hear the bracing, you're getting to hear the guitar itself as opposed to just the pickup coming through the monitor. I'm a big Gibson guy, I love Gibson acoustics, and this is the way to get that iconic Gibson sound for a bit less money and have some fun modern features, but not too modern because it originally came around in the 60s. And as always, all the product links are down below for these Gibson generations and the ones I will talk about in a second. Right, one of my favourite guitar players of all time is Mr. Jack White, and if you didn't see my Jack White gear guide from a few weeks ago, pause this video, and again, linked in the description box down below, will be a link, go check it out, because I adore Jack White. It's an iconic sound, and again, same as Nirvana, even if you're not massive on the White Stripes, the Dead Weather, the Raconteurs, or Jack White solo stuff, you can't dispute the fact that he's left such a mark on the world. He's respected by Jimmy Page, he's respected by Eric Clapton, all these guys love Jack White, and he opened a store in Nashville, Third Man Records, which is a recording studio, massive studio space, as well as a record store to buy vinyl records to keep the vinyl record industry alive, because he's very old school, is Mr. Jack White. Beautiful store, you can record your own vinyl there and then in a cool little booth and stuff. It's iconic, I'm dying to go there. And now I can go a bit sooner rather than later because they've opened a store in London. Based in Soho, the music heart of London, you can rock up to Third Man Records, buy some Jack White and Third Man merchandise, buy some amazing vinyl records from Third Man Records artists, as well as other artists, I presume, because Jack just loves music in general. There were some special releases for the release at the week as well. Paul Weller, David Ruffin, and The Jesus and Mary Chin. I'm not sure who the last one is, but they all released new music for the Third Man opening. And to celebrate this, Jack stayed in London and did a live gig from Damien Hirst's balcony in the center of Soho. He rocked his beautiful Telecaster, and more info on the Telecaster on that link down below, as well as an Acoustasonic Fender guitar, because he's a big Fender guy. He likes his EVHs and his Telecasters and stuff. Did a gig where he plays all the classics. Dead Leaves on the Dirty Ground, We Are Gonna Be Friends, Lazaretto, and obviously Seven Nation Army. There's a great video of him singing Seven Nation Army, and the entire streets of London are singing along with that now iconic riff. But I mentioned that there's a gig venue underneath the Third Man Record store, the Blue Basement. He also did a separate gig in the Blue Basement, playing some Raconteurs songs, played some Dead Weather songs, I think. And yeah, if you're in London, get yourself to Third Man Records before I get there and buy every single thing from that merch store. And the venue looks amazing. If you get a chance to play there, please do it and let me know what you think of that venue. Awesome. So pleased this is in London now. Now, next up, Shure undoubtedly the biggest name in microphones, have just released a beautiful new microphone, a miniature version of their extremely awesome SM7B. This is the MV7X. Now, this is whether you're podcasting or recording vocals on a budget, but I've seen everyone just podcasting with this microphone. It's the ultimate little podcasting microphone. It will fit into any audio interface via XLR. And as you can tell by the pictures, it has the same form as that iconic SM7B. Here's what Shure have to say. The Shure MV7X is a professional quality XLR dynamic microphone, ideal for close mic applications. Close mic applications. That require vocal integrity with a balanced tone. Voice isolation technology ensures the microphone is laser focused on your voice and does not capture any unwanted background noise to give you perfect recordings in imperfect environments. The attractive and durable all-metal design features an adjustable yoke that can be mounted onto any variety of microphone stand for flexible placement options. Now, the original SM7B is, in my opinion, one of the best microphones on the planet. Whether you're recording vocals, whether you're recording a guitar amp, it's great for getting, it's great for capturing things that are hard-hitting because it captures every single nuance in what you're the audio source that you're putting into the microphone. And this is just a smaller variant. So the original one was great for really loud guitar amps and people screaming into it to capture every single nuance of their voice. This one, slightly smaller, so when you speak softly into it, it will capture every single thing in your voice. Some specs: highly optimized dynamic element and voice isolation technology, optimized frequency response for rich and natural vocal reproduction, rugged all-metal construction, adjustable integrated yoke for easy positioning on every standard threaded stand or boom. Yeah, this is a great little thing, and I kind of want to get one for doing voiceovers in the future. Here with PMT is the ultimate little voiceover tool, or podcasting, or little home studio vocal singy things. Really cool. Now back to music. I'm one of my favorite bands growing up, with some epic riffs and epic outfits. Limp Bizkit have released a new single, Dad Vibes. They kind of leaked it, or like gave us a little sneak peek at their Lollapalooza show earlier in 2021, when it was the last song of the set, but they just came into the crowd and played through the PA system. You kind of got the vibe it was going to be called Dad Vibes when Fred Durst was cutting about in his dad, he's a dad now in real life, but gone are the days of the backwards red cap. He's rocking a handlebar mustache, he has his tinted red shades on and his comfy loafers, and he's cutting about singing about being a dad. Actually, Wes Borland looked a lot more familiar on stage as opposed to seeing Fred Durst cut about with his dad dancing, but the tune is absolutely mega. I've always loved Limp Bizkit. They get a lot of hate and stuff, but Wes himself is one of the most riff-driven guitar players. His riffs are absolutely badass, whether it's his own stuff or Limp Bizkit stuff. He's just kick-ass. So this is teasing an album coming very, very soon. The song is called Dad Vibes. Check it out, it's linked down below, and I'm very happy about it. Let me know what you think about Limp Bizkit down below in the comments. Changed the game for me when I was younger. Hell yeah. It's their first bit of new music since 2011, which was the album Gold Cobra, and tell me the riff to Gold Cobra isn't absolutely epic. And I always say that Limp Bizkit has some of the best recorded drum sounds on the planet, and that is just the truth right there. More musical goodies. Alesis have just announced the Mark II variant of their V-series keyboards. There's the V25 Mark II, the V49 Mark II, and the V61 Mark II, and those numbers correlate to how many lovely keys you have on these keyboards. Now, the old V-series were the ultimate plug-and-play keyboard and MIDI controller for musicians out there. I'm not that techie based, so when it comes to doing, well, I do production stuff as well, personally, so when it comes to this kind of production stuff, I'm not like a super crazy DJ. I like things that plug in and play and get sounds immediately off the bat. And you could always do this with the V series, at least his stuff, but now with the Mark IIs, they just expanded it to the next awesome plateau. And here are some specs. These USB bus powered MIDI controllers have, so bus powered means it's powered by the USB. There's not like an external power supply that you need it. You can all just rock it from the USB or Thunderbolt or whatever they're called now. These new USB bus-powered MIDI controllers have everything needed to make a lasting impact on your productions. All V-series controllers pack the same valuable production, 8 velocity-sensitive backlit pads with full level and note repeat controls, so those are the little pads that you can like do drum stuff on. 4 MIDI-assignable knobs for controlling virtual instruments and recording software, so you can change parameters of things while you're like live recording with the V-series. pitch bends and modulation wheels to go up in pitch and to turn the modulation up, octave buttons to access the full range of the keyboard. So even if you do get one of the smaller ones, like the V25, the octave buttons will let you go up and down the parts of the keyboard to save you having to get a bigger one, but sometimes it's fun to have just a big one. There's a sustain pedal input in the back, as you'd expect. The three models also feature virtual arpeggiators with six different modes, tap tempos, time division, gates, and swing controls. And all V-Series keyboards include MPC Beats software to start recording right out the box. And for more information on these amazing little keyboards, click the link in the description box down below, as always. Now let's talk about some good news. I've got a couple of really cool stories. The first one is very famous. Mark Hoppus from Blink-182 has announced that he's cancer-free. Earlier in the year, Mark Hoppus told the world on Instagram that he'd been diagnosed with stage 4 diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, a form of cancer, which was really sucked. No one likes to hear this kind of stuff, and he actually said he was scared and doesn't know what to do. But he's been through chemotherapy and everything's been going great, and now he's cancer-free, which is absolutely awesome. And the pop-punk world and the music and guitar and bass world is just absolutely buzzing for him, including myself. Bravo, Mark, you've absolutely nailed it. He said his hair's growing back after chemo, but it's coming in white. So he doesn't know whether to rock it either like a Doc Brown from Back to the Future or rock a kind of George Clooney thing. So he's taking it all in his stride, and it's absolutely awesome to see. So yeah, bit of good news for you. Mark Hoppus, Blink-182, is now cancer-free. There's a great video online of him playing the entirety of Enema of the State. Check that out. It's really, really cool. Go on, Mark. Good lad. And finally, to end this episode of DGN, I was sent an awesome video. I was sent an awesome video of a five-year-old in a PMT store in PMT Manchester playing Smells Like Teen Spirit. Leonardo, the kid in the video, rocks a Squire 60s classic vibe Strat, Smells Like Teen Spirit, 5 years old, playing Smells Like Teen Spirit. And I was like, this is crazy. Got talking, and not to him, I assume his mum or something. He has a YouTube channel where not only plays Smells Like Teen Spirit, there's videos of him playing Eric Clapton's Layer. Wonderful tonight. This five-year-old, and he's singing as well. It's not just solo guitar covers, it's singers as well, and 5 years old. Doing this is crazy, and I hope you enjoy the Squire Classic Vibe 60s Strat in PMT Manchester, dude. Keep rocking and enjoy, folks. This is badass. Please check out Leonardo on YouTube. Give him a subscribe to give him the support he needs, because one day he's going to be on the telly. He's going to be playing Wembley Stadium. He's going to be playing Madison Square Garden. And save some tickets for me, Leonardo, please, because I think you're epic. That's been this week's episode of DGN. If you want to submit your awesome guitar playing video, send it through to submissions@pmtonline.co.uk and get your chance to be on next week's edition of DGN. Talk about your YouTube channel and Instagram or whatever you want and just have a lot of fun, but Leonardo will take a lot of beating. Comment down below your favorite part of this week's DGN, and like I said 1,000 times, all the links are in the description box down below. Give it a like and subscribe, and I will see you next time.